The channel, and today we are going to do the another 10 questions in 10 minutes of oral pathology chapter skin and vesicular lesions. So I hope you are doing fine with this, because I think as many as MCQs we can do, we're going to do things bit. Okay, so let's start to the things. We will be starting with the question number 21, because the previous questions we have done in the earlier videos. Okay, so question number 21 is asking about the histopathological study of lichen planus. As you can show, histopathological study of lichen planus. So here in this question, you should know about the histopathological features. So I'm telling you the histopathological features one by one. So here you can see there is sawtooth appearance of retipacts. This is the first point that you should remember, sawtooth appearance of retipacts. Next is liquefactive degeneration of basal layer. Next is sievert bodies also called as hyaline bodies, colloid bodies, fibrillar bodies. There is also bands of subepithelial mononuclear infiltrate. Now these bands of subepithelial mononuclear infiltrate, they contain T lymphocytes predominantly, along with this they also contain histocytes. They also have hyperparakeratosis or hyperorthokeratosis, and they also have thickening of granuloma. So these are the features, histological features of lichen planus, and according to these features, option number B is right, that is the presence of T lymphocytes predominantly. Let's jump to question number 22, which of the following is inherited as autosomal dominant trait. Okay, so as you see the options, lichen planus, pemphigoid and pemphigus, all these three are autoimmune diseases. They are not inherited autosomally dominantly. That's why option D is the answer, because white swan's nevus is autosomally dominantly inherited. Okay, so in this you have to learn the things. Now next is 23 question, that is LE cell phenomenon. Now what is LE? LE is Langerhans cell phenomenon, and what is it actually? That when the cell dies, now the cellular component of that dead cell is being phagocytosed by some neutrophils. That phenomenon is LE cell, and when it occurs, the LE test comes out to be positive. So here, LE cell phenomenon is seen in option number D, that is systemic lupus erythematosus. Why it is seen in this, it is not mentioned in the answers, but yes, it is written that here, in this phenomenon, when the blood serum gets mixed up with the buffy coat of normal blood, it will lead to this phenomenon. And this phenomenon only develops in the last option. And here, when you see, there is a rosette of neutrophils which is surrounding the pale mass in between. So there is a pale mass in the center, and around it there is a rosette of neutrophils. So when you see this structure, you will be definitely knowing that yes, it is LE cell, and they are formed in SLE. So it's not blood related, that's why the first three options are not correct. Next is the 24th question, that what is lichenoid reactions. So let me tell you what are lichenoid reactions. Lichenoid reactions are the drug induced reactions which exhibit histopathological features similar to lichen planus. That's why they're called as oral lichen planus like reactions, because the histologic features are same, but these are drug induced, and these drugs can be a number of drugs. I'm showing this to you that they can be antihypertensive drugs, they can be NSAIDs, they can be penicillins, they can be epsons, ketoconazole, streptomycin, tetracycline, chloroquine. So all these drugs, oral hypoglycemic agents, sulfamethoxazole, all these drugs, these are the drugs which are showing lichenoid reactions. So in the question, it is demanding that what the cause, and here the cause is the drugs. So option A is correct. Jump to question number 25, that is intraepithelial vacuolation with formation of vesicle or bullae intraepithelially above the basal layer is seen in. So whenever a question comes to you in which there is intraepithelial formation of bullae and vesicles and vacuoles, your answer is pemphigus. So you have to learn this, that yes, it is seen in pemphigus. So answer is C option for the question number 25. Question number 26,
Now, a 40-year-old woman reports with a complaint of burning sensation. So here it's a 40-year-old woman having a complaint of burning sensation. Now, clinical examination reveals lesions consisting of radiating white striations. So whenever we do the examination of this, we see radiating white lines in the retiform arrangement affecting the buccal mucosa, affecting lips, tongue, gingiva, bilaterally. So there is bilateral involvement. Okay. So on incisor biopsy, it is suggested with lichen planus. It is shown that the diagnosis is lichen planus. So the following are the different clinical forms of lichen planus, etc. Okay. So in this question, it's a tricky question. They are asking me just a simple thing that what are the types of lichen planus, and you have to find out the old one out. So the answer is D, because variegated form is not found in lichen planus. I've told you earlier also the types of lichen planus. So the answer is D. It's the same repeat question. Now let's jump to question 27 and 28. And before doing question number 27 and 28, I'm going to show you a simple tabular form. Now this tabular form, different types of disease are there and their tests are there. So first of all, you need to know that pemphigus, lichen planus, pemphigoid, different types of pemphigoid, either it be cicatricial or bullous pemphigoid, or lichen planus, pemphigus, and different types of lupus erythematosus, either it be discoid lupus erythematosus, systemic lupus erythematosus, or erythema multiforme. These are the different types in which fluorescence test is seen. So the 27th question is asking you that in which type of the disease the fluorescence is seen. So the answer to this is B and C. There are two options correct in this question. Pemphigus vulgaris also shows immunofluorescence test, and lupus erythematosus also shows this test. Now, question number 28. This question is asking that patchy distribution of like immunofluorescence is seen in basement membranous patchy distribution, like patchy immunofluorescence is seen in which? So answer to this question is answer to this question is pemphigoid. Now let's see to this table. You can see here that cicatricial pemphigoid and bullous pemphigoid both show patchy linear distribution, and erythema multiforme also show patchy linear distribution. So as in the options, erythema multiforme is not present. That's why the answer goes with pemphigoid, that is option number C. Next, the question number 29, that is erosive lichen planus resembles which of the following? Here you have to see that which type of gingivitis is seen in which type of disease. So the answer is D, square meter gingivitis, because square meter gingivitis is an oral manifestation. Now it's oral manifestation of three types of disease. One is oral lichen planus, second is pemphigoid, that is cicatricial pemphigoid, and then third is pemphigus. So you can also see that cicatricial pemphigoid is also known with different names. Yes, cicatricial pemphigoid is also known with different names. It is also called as benign mucous membrane pemphigoid. It is also called as pemphigus vulgaris. It is also called as Hailey-Hailey syndrome. So these are different names. You should not confuse that cicatricial pemphigoid, also called as benign mucous membrane pemphigoid, also called as pemphigus vulgaris and Hailey-Hailey. So these are the three diseases in which old manifestation is D, square meter gingivitis. Now let's jump to the last question, that is question number 30. A 60-year-old woman got severe bulle and target lesions with erythema around the halo, and there is genital lesions also. So which type of syndrome is this? Answer is A, that is Steven-Johnson syndrome. Now why Steven-Johnson syndrome? Because in Steven-Johnson syndrome, there is involvement of three things: oral, ocular, and genital. So there are oral lesions also, ocular involvement also, and genital lesions also. That's definitely Steven-Johnson syndrome. So whenever there is bulle, target lesions, and there is erythema around the halo, and then genital lesions, then you should definitely go with Steven-Johnson syndrome. So these are the 10 questions that we have discussed today. And in the next video, we'll be discussing the next 10 questions. And I think this is the best way to do oral pathology, because doing as many as questions makes memory better instead of reading chapters. So that's all for today. I hope you like the video. If you like it, please do subscribe my channel. Thank you.